Good morning, UCA family. This is Ms. Briner. I'm the Visual and Performing Arts Coordinator. And I just want to welcome you this morning. I'm glad you're up and we're all together. And this is our second to last online chapel. We have one more after this. This morning, the high school worship team has prepared a couple songs. And then John Bennett and Dr. Lynn have a message that they've prepared for us. So it's going to be a great morning. Please, would you pray with me? Father God, thank you so much for this morning and this time that we have to come together as a family and to focus on you and to learn about you and to worship you, God. We ask for your presence with us, Lord, each individually in our homes, that you would be reminding us of your care. You would be reminding us of your love. We would be able to look around and see you working in us and through us and around us in other people, God. We love you. We want to show it more and more. Please open those opportunities up for us, God, to express how much you love us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Hi, my name is John Bennett. I'm the current director of international student programming at UCA.
这位是本尼特老师，他是现任国际事工部主任，我是林老师，我将在下学年接任主任。And
God has put it on our hearts to do the message this week, and we're so honored and blessed to be able to share what God's been speaking to us. And because of our unique positions in the school, we're going to do the message a little differently today. We're going to be teaming up to deliver today's message. I'm going to be doing the English portion, and Dr. Lin will be doing the Mandarin portion.
神感动我们传讲今天的信息，有机会和大家分享神给我们的感动，我们非常荣幸，因为我们在学校里特别的责任区，今天分享信息的方式也不太一样，我们会分工合作。
And as you're likely aware, we've all been wearing these masks. And for most of us, we've never had to wear them before. Unless we work in healthcare or construction or food service areas, this might be our first time wearing masks. Well, outside of Halloween too, I suppose.
最近我们常常要戴上口罩。 我们当中许多人从前可能从来没有戴过口罩，除非是在医疗、建筑或者餐饮行业工作，或者是万圣节，否则我们当中有些人可能最近是第一次需要戴上口罩。And
it can be uncomfortable, and I personally don't enjoy smelling my own breath. But during this time, masks are important. In addition, these masks represent how we should act in times of uncertainty. In this piece of cloth, there are two ideas we want to share today. One is metaphorical, and the other is a literal idea. And both will set up our reading today from the book of Colossians.
口罩戴起来并不舒服。我其实也不是那么喜欢一直闻自己的口气，但是口罩很重要。它代表了在现在这个充满变数的疫情当中，我们应该如何行动。借由口罩。 我们想要讨论两个概念，口罩的象征和实际意义。这些探讨会预备我们了解接下来要读的圣经哥罗西书。So
I'm going to put on my mask. And so when I wear this mask, what is covered when I wear this? And what is left uncovered? What is blocked and what is left unfiltered? Of course, my mouth and my nose are the things that are covered. But my eyes and my ears are left free. On a symbolic level, this represents an opportunity we are given in this time. This season of our lives is a perfect time to pay more attention to the ways that God is moving in the world around us.
当我们戴上口罩的时候，像我现在把口罩戴上，有哪一些部分被遮住，有哪一些部分不会被遮住？ 没错，遮住的是我的鼻子和嘴，没遮住的是我的眼睛和耳朵。从象征的角度，这代表一个属于现今时期的大好机会。现在正是我们学习更多的关注上帝如何在我们周遭世界行动的大好时机。Instead
of sharing our thoughts and opinions, what if we silently observe the beauty of creation, the mountains, the trees, the smiles of our loved ones? What if instead of speaking all the time, we just listen to our family, to our neighbors? What if we remain silent and instead look for the hope and joy that surrounds us?
与其滔滔不绝地分享我们的想法和意见，我们是不是能够安静地观察 上帝美丽的创造，观看高山、树木和我们亲爱的人脸上的微笑。我们是否能闭上嘴，专心聆听，听我们自己的家人和邻舍说话？我们是否能安静地观看身边围绕着的盼望和喜乐？But
also, what if we pause and observe the hurt and suffering in our world? And people we can better understand, and as a result, we can better serve. What if we listen for what God is trying to tell us in this time?
除此之外, 我们是不是也能关注世界上的伤痛和痛苦, 好让我们能够对人有更多的理解, 好让我们能更好地服侍他们, 我们是否能听见, 此时此刻, 上帝究竟想要告诉我们什么?
Literally, though, this mask is essential. Our international students and their families have worn masks even before this pandemic. And it wasn't just to protect themselves. They wore it out of consideration for others. You see, wearing a mask helps keep the sickness from getting out. And thus, it is loving of us, even if we don't think we're sick in this time, to wear a mask just in case, at least until the virus is contained.
从实际意义来说，口罩也是非常重要的。 我们当中的国际学生和家人在疫情扩散之前已经开始戴上口罩。戴口罩并不只是想要保护自己，戴口罩也因为他们爱身边的人。口罩可以帮助减少疾病的传播，所以戴口罩也是一种爱的行动。即使我们并不觉得自己得病，以防万一把口罩戴上，直到病毒传播。
And as I said before, masks are uncomfortable. And being told we have to wear them can make us frustrated. And we're already feeling angry and hurt and sad because we cannot see our friends or do all the things we want to do. And these feelings can lead us to act in ways that hurt others and hurt our relationship with God. So Dr. Lin and I have come up with an acronym to help us stay strong, not just today, but when the storm passes.
就像我之前说的，口罩戴起来并不很舒服。当我们因为和朋友见不了面，不能随心所欲地做自己从前做的事，已经憋着一肚子气和难受，还要遵守戴口罩的指令，这可能会让我们更不舒服。有时候这些挫败感、负面情绪可能导致我们对身边的人发脾气，伤害我们和人。 和上帝的关系，所以我和林老师想出下面这个首字母缩写的点子，希望提醒大家在疫情风暴之中之后，怎么样坚定地照着上帝的心意过日子。The
acronym is MASK, M-A-S-K, and the M stands for meditating on God's word.
我们今天想出来的点子就是 mask, M 是默想神的话。
The A stands for acting according to God's word.
A 代表的是照神的话行动。
The S stands for seeking opportunities to share God's love.
S 这个字母代表的是寻求机会分享神的爱。
And the K represents keeping God's promises in our hearts.
K这个字母代表的是将神的应许藏在心里。
So today, let's start by meditating or reflecting and thinking about God's word. Today's reading comes from the book of Colossians, chapter 3, starting in verse 7 through verse 17.
我们先来谈谈默想神的话。今天的经文是 新约哥罗西书三章七到十七节。
And I'll give you a moment to find it if you'd like to follow along.
我们给大家一点时间找到这段经文。
Starting with verse 7. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived. But now you must also rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices, and have put on a new self, which is being renewed in knowledge in the image of its creator. Here there is no Gentile or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all.
哥罗西书三章第七节，当你们在这些事中活着的时候，也曾这样行过。 但现在你们要弃绝这一切的事，以及恼恨、愤怒、恶毒、毁谤，并口中污秽的言语，不要彼此说谎，因你们已经脱去旧人和旧人的行为，穿上了新人，这新人在知识上渐渐更新，正如造他主的形象。在此并不分希利尼人、犹太人、受割礼的、未受割礼的、化外人、希古提人、为奴的、自主的，唯有基督是包括一切，又住在个人之内。
Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
接下来是12节到17节。所以你们既是神的选民，圣洁蒙爱的人，就要存怜悯、恩慈、谦虚、温柔、忍耐的心。倘若这人与那人有嫌隙，总要彼此包容，彼此饶恕。主怎样饶恕了你们，你们也要怎样饶恕人。在这一切之外，要存着爱心，爱心就是联络全德的，又要叫基督的平安在你们心里做主，你们也为此蒙召，归为一体，且要存感谢的心。当用各样的智慧，把基督的道理丰丰富富地存在心里，用诗章、颂词、灵歌，彼此教导，互相劝解，心被恩感，歌颂神。无论做什么，或说话，或行事，都要奉主耶稣的名，借着他感谢父神。
The first part of the chapter, which we did not read, deals with major, more easily identifiable sins like greed and lust. But the first part of the section we read deals with things that are also destructive, yet we are often not aware of them. Things like anger, or the words that we say that are unkind and often not true.
哥罗西书三章前面第五节的部分提到了重大显而易见的罪，比如贪婪和情欲。但是我们刚刚读的第七八节讲到的罪同样有破坏力，可是我们却常常不容易察觉，比如说隐藏的恼恨、愤怒、恶毒，或者是我们说出不真实、不讨神喜悦的话。
As I said before, when we are stressed or hurt, when our world seems to be going from bad to worse, we can easily become frustrated. We become angry at ourselves, at other people, at groups of people, and even at God. In a way, anger is like a virus that can be spread through hurtful words and actions. If we act out of hatred and anger, are we acting according to God's word for us?
就像之前说的，当我们感到压力、受伤的时候，当我们所处的世界似乎每况愈下的时候，我们很容易感到沮丧。于是，我们对自己生气，对别人生气，对别的团体生气，甚至有可能对上帝生气。有时候愤怒也像病毒，能借着破坏性的话语和行动传播。想一想，如果我们依着愤怒、仇恨行动，这样子的行为是照着上帝的心意和教导吗？
Once we begin walking with the Lord, we start to shed what Paul calls our old self. The old self is the person who lies and hates, who wants what others have and gives into temptation. But when we follow Jesus, we put on a new self.
当我们开始与主同行，我们就开始脱去保罗所说的旧人。旧人会说谎，会仇恨，会嫉妒，会对试探屈服。但是当我们跟从主耶稣，我们就开始成为新造的人。
We put on love, and we let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts.
这个新人存着爱心，叫基督的平安在你们心里做主。
It's important to remember that in this part of the Bible, Paul is writing from prison. He is trapped. He is facing hard times. But he reminds the church he's writing to that we as Christ followers must not have anger and hatred even in our worst situations. Because even in his own struggle, Paul shares the gospel. He has the peace of Christ in his heart, which lets him love others even in his pain.
千万记住，当年使徒保罗写哥罗西书时，他正在监牢里，他被捆锁，处境艰难。但是他提笔写信给当时的教会，告诉教会，我们作为基督徒，即使处境糟糕透顶，也不能心里蓄积愤怒和仇恨。即便保罗自己在挣扎中，他还是能够宣讲福音，因为他有基督的平安在他心里。保罗自己在痛苦中也还能爱他人。
We too are called to act according to God's will and share Christ's love because we are new creations in Christ. We are put on good things like humility and kindness. The word kindness in this context is a virtue of someone who holds the needs and wants of other people as important as their own. That's why doing small things that might be difficult or make us uncomfortable, like wearing masks, is so important.
就像保罗，我们也蒙上帝选召，要照着他的心意分享基督的爱。因为在耶稣基督里，我们是新造的人，我们就能够存谦卑恩慈的心。恩慈在这里是一种德性，是能够把他人的需要看作和自己的需要一样重要。就是从这个角度，类似戴口罩这样的行动，即使就会让我们自己觉得不舒服的行动，是这么的重要。
We are given a beautiful opportunity in these dark and crazy times to show the love and kindness that God has shown us. And there are many ways to do that beyond wearing a mask to protect others.
在这个看似黑暗疯狂的时代，上帝给我们美好的机会，让我们可以对世界展现他的恩慈和爱。而这些方式当然不止于戴上口罩保护他人。
One of our international families donated 500 masks for our school and hundreds of masks to local hospitals in our area. Our church, ALFC, shared produce and other gifts with our families. And we have seen students and families sharing words of encouragement when they can't physically be near each other. And we have nurses and doctors and other workers who risk their health to serve our community.
比如说，我们当中有一个国际学生的家庭捐赠了500个口罩给学校。还有几百个口罩给附近医院。我们的教会 ALFC 慷慨地和大家分享食物和其他的礼物。这段时间，我们也看到学生和家长们，即使不能彼此面对面，还是常常鼓励打气。我们当中的医生、护士和其他医疗人员，更是冒着健康的风险服务社区。
In addition, the amount of prayer that has been lifted up for our community, our country, and our world is remarkable. And though it can be hard, we've also been able to spend more time with our families. We have found new creative ways to connect.
这段时间，为我们的社区、我们的国家和我们的世界献上的祷告，让人赞叹。即使有时候不容易，这段时间也让我们可以跟最亲密的家人多一些时间在一起。我们也继续的用新鲜的、有创意的方式连结。
So UCA family, As we continue into the unknown, facing whatever comes our way, let's put on our masks. May we meditate on scriptures, acting according to God's word, seeking opportunities to share God's love, and keep God's promises in our heart.
所以，亲爱的UCA家人， 当我们继续在这一段不确定的旅程往前走时， 我们不知道前面会面对什么， 但是让我们记得戴上我们的口罩， 让我们常常思想神的话， 照他的话来行动， 找机会去分享他的爱， 把神的应许存在我们心里。
Let's remember, we have the peace of Jesus Christ in our hearts. Let's put on love, and let's give thanks for all that God has blessed us with, especially for life in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
让我们在心里守住耶稣基督的平安, 让我们存着耶稣的爱, 让我们对上帝给我们的所有祝福, 心怀感恩, 特别是主耶稣基督里的新生命。
And so to conclude, I'm going to say a prayer in English. And if you are at home, just feel free to close your eyes and bow your heads as I pray at the end of our word, our message. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all that you've blessed us with, whether it's family, friends, jobs, or even just a community that we can rally around. God, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your son, Jesus. We thank you for all the promises you've given, that one day there will be no sickness, no pain, no hurt, that we'll be able to spend eternity with you, God. And so we look forward to that day. In the meanwhile, may our words and actions be light in this darkness, and may you help us to stay strong in the midst of all of this uncertainty. Thank you, Lord, for your son, Jesus. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.